Welcome back to Sahara TV. My name is Rudolph Okonkwo. It's been more than 3 weeks since the story broke that the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority, NCAA, with the approval of the Minister of Aviation, Mrs. Stella Oduah, bought two bulletproof BMW cars for the aviation ministry. The fallout has continued. Last week, the Airline Operators of Nigeria, AON, said that it will no longer pay charges to the aviation agencies in protest for what he called corruption in the ministry. Mohammed Takur, the former deputy director of the Airline Operators of Nigeria, who made the statement, is now joining us to discuss the situation in the aviation ministry. Mr. Mohammed Takur, welcome to Sahara TV.
Thank you very much.
Let me start by asking you, because we saw a statement issued yesterday by the Federal Airport Authority of Nigeria saying essentially that you are fake, that you don't work for any airline in Nigeria, you hold no position at the Airline Operators of Nigeria. So who do you work for and what is your position at AON?
Well, first of all, I would like to tell you that if you have seen my statement, my reaction to that statement, let me answer your question directly. I have been a spokesman of Airline Operator of Nigeria for decades. The person who issued the statement, he did it on his own, because if he remember, one airline refused to pay the navigation charges for NAMA, I'm the one who even went to the media and spoke that airline should pay. And the main reason, because at that time, I believe we have a meeting and we agree that we are going to pay. So after we left, some airlines say they are not going to pay. And I said, okay, we have to obey our promise. You know, you don't need to promise and you didn't pay, because we see there is an improvement in the airspace and there is a lot of things they have put in. And we don't want a situation where we go back to where we are coming from. And that's why we start paying that navigation charges, pay as you go. So it is at that time, so I'm not the spokesman of the AON. It is now that I'm not the spokesman of the AON. So the truth of the matter is, I'm the spokesman of the AON. And before we make this statement, the larger airline in Nigeria, Arif Chiamang, I caught, he called on the federal government to sanitize the industry. Do you understand? And the most of our members, they are so concerned. And we have a meeting, we agree, and it is not alleged money to go. And I have been directed to issue that statement. And let me tell you, most of the airlines, some of them could not come out directly to show their anger because of what? Because of intimidation. I will give you an example. I have been a spokesman in the channel television in Nigeria. When the same person make a call and call me as an ordinary station manager of a particular airline, which he mentioned that I'm a station manager. I have never been a station manager of that company. I have been a director in that company, and I have 12 service civil aircraft in that company. Then guess what? He said the airline is crumbled. When the aircraft is having three aircraft, but 2 days after that statement, because of their imagination, they went and grounded that airline. Well, I'm not in that airline at the time that I'm talking, at the time he's making that comment. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. Before you go for that, we'll go into details, but I want to clear something very well. They said that. How did you come about that statement? Did you meet with certain people and you all agreed that this is a statement we are going to issue? Or the way they say that is from your figment of your imagination. How did you come about that statement? Because we want to know the basis of that statement before we go ahead.
The statement is a meeting that we hold and we all agree that I should issue that statement. I did not issue that statement at all.
Can you tell us who were at the meeting? Which airline representative were at the meeting?
You have the chairman of the Airline Operator of Nigeria, the current chairman now, Arik.
okay.
which represented that they are members. I hope you understand, and you have to all the members of AON, the only two airlines who are not among, because we wanted to investigate those people for their involvement in one scandal or the other with the ministry concerning the limousine they are talking about. One of our members went to claim that those limousine is belong to him, which we realized that maybe somebody from the ministry asked them to go and claim it to make a statement, because from the beginning they asked him to make a statement under which he refused. And I called him personally on phone, and I asked him that I want you to clear this issue. What concern you with those limousine? And he told me that he cannot say anything. Whatever PAM is going to say, NAMA is going to say, let them say, he's not going to say a word. I said, it's okay. So then suddenly we realized that the Senate invited him to come and answer those questions. Do you understand? So based on that, we know one, two people who have been involved, because they are having some business with the airport in Abuja, in Port Harcourt, in Kano. They give them that, and they are working together. Do you understand? So that's the only member that is not involved.
Okay. Now, in your statement,
I'm talking to you, all the private operator, we are all together, we all agree. I hope you understand that we should issue this statement.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's clear now. Now, let me ask you, in that statement, you alleged that infrastructures at Nigerian airports were obsolete. You also said that navigation aids were epileptic and that there was a lack of accountability in the utilization of aviation taxes. Now, Nigerians who may be reading that will say, tell me something I don't know. When did the organization notice these problems? I mean, it's something that we have known for a long time. When did you notice these problems?
You see, what we noticed, we did not notice that there is a lot of stealing, you know, until when this story break. Then when it has break, we couldn't believe that they can go to that level. But you have some kind of thing you are trying to see the way the parasitic normally behave. We realize that when they stole the money, what we realize, when they stole the money, the first story they will come out with it is airline are owing debt. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Then they will start saying airline are not paying. So now, after just before the break of this particular story, they have already, there is a discussion going on. Even the Senate is asking the NAMA to go to Senate and present all the airline operators who are owing. Do you understand?
Mm.
Then this story break. Then we say, excuse me, so these people can go to this extent, spending all this money, you don't have people who are going for training, people are owing a lot of money. Then the staff, most of the senior staff of those parasitas, starting complaining to us that, you know, we cannot talk, you people have to stand up. Among the people who are even in the industry, they are in support of what we said. But the truth of the matter is as simple as ABCD. We have seen a corruption. We are not saying we are not going to pay our debt, or we are not going to pay our current bill. Let the government clear those issues, because we can't continue collecting 5% from passenger. It's even better we return that money so that we can charge cheaper airfare, because the majority of those charges are too much for us, and we are suffering. Do you understand?
Mm.
So that's why we said, okay, we can't pay this debt, we can't pay the current bill. There is a particular bill, really, that nothing we can do about it.
Mm.
It's just like what we did before.
Mm.
We informed the Federal Airport Authority as an airline operator, we are not going to collect passenger service from passenger to give to you.
Mm.
Before, when we collect that money, we normally pay every month. So we don't want to collect it anymore. If you want to collect it, go and put your toll gate and collect your money from your passenger.
Mm.
So what they do, they said, okay, you are not going to collect it on our behalf. We said, okay, we can collect it if you are going to give us commission. But if there is no commission, collect your money.
Mm.
So they went ahead and say, okay, from today, no passenger will pass any terminal until he have a sticker. So we were forced, we have to go and pay for that sticker in order for us to put for every ticket.
Mm.
I hope you understand. Mm. So for that particular one, we cannot say we are not going to buy the sticker, because it's not like you give for the printing of your ticket, or you bring a software intelligent person who is going to put a software in your system. Definitely you have to pay him. Do you understand?
Mm.
So that's what we are talking about. But landing, parking, passenger ticket sale, ODC, office space, electricity, which we are paying yearly, monthly, before the end of this one, we are not going to pay. If the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria acted very fast by removing the corrupt FIFO, then airline will reconcile they have been, and they will pay every day they charge us.
Now, let me ask you, can you give us an idea how much money your organizations are paying to the aviation agencies?
Frankly speaking, it has gone to billion. I will give you an example of one airline. Take, for example, Arabia, who is having at least minimum almost more than 14 or 20-something aircraft flying in this country. So you can imagine for every landing of this aircraft, you pay 14,000 naira for any airport. You have more than 120 landing. So now, if you are paying, if he's paying that kind of money landing a day, for example, you calculated that amount, then you talk about 5% for every ticket they sell. If they are charging 24,000 naira, 5% of that ticket sale go to the NCAA every month. Mm. Then you have another money which you back. Do you understand?
Mm.
Then you have a fuel which you take. Out of that fuel that you take, the oil marketer are charging almost 1 naira.
Mm.
Extra, which is on top of the money you are paying for the tour, and it for a liter, and it has gone to Federal Airport Authority. An oil marketer is paying more than 20 million a month. How many oil marketers we have? Because an oil marketer can give one airline about 1,500,000 liters a day.
Mm.
We are not talking about international. Do you understand? We are talking about local operator.
Mm.
So it's a huge money. You take only one airline. You take Aero. You take Nebu. You take Ghana. You take other airline, and you put them together. It's a huge money that we are paying.
Now, what was the goal of the money? Was supposed to be used for what? Do you
the
have an idea?
The money supposed to be utilized. For example, the 5% NCAA. Excuse me. The 5% NCAA, they normally share it with all the agencies. Varia, Fincap, Limit, NAMA. TAN is not part of it because they are collecting their 5% from, 1% or 1,000 naira per passenger. Do you understand? So they are not part of that sharing.
Mm.
So that's how they are sharing those money. And if you look at the corruption, the way they support all the money, from the NCAA, where you have a technical people, down to Federal Airport Authority, where you are paying London parking passenger service. Then you go to NAMA, you go to Zaria, you see the huge amount they have supported, you know, for only the Ministry of Aviation, Abuja.
Mm.
So when you look at all this now, it just recently that there is a rain in Lagos. So if there is any rain in Lagos, we have two runways. One is, we call it 18 right. The other one, we call it 18 left. The one who is already in the local. Let me tell you, the car will tell you you should go to 18 right international to land. So if you are going there to land, the other one is already flooded. So they don't care about what they are going to fix to maintain that place and renew that terminal, that particular runway to do it right. They are care about the car they are going to drive.
Mm.
And the car is not only for one person. The car is for the GM and his wife.
Mm. Now, let me, in one interview, you said that the aviation authorities were more interested in making money than passenger safety. Can you explain how that is the case?
Okay. The Minister of Aviation, when she come in, she went and introduced a law, which they call Directory of General Aviation, GA. Policy and the procedure manual. You see, if you look at the policy, is already a problem, because she has already said that particular, the first edition, June 2013, approved by the DG, Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority. You see, when you are changing a policy from the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority Act 2006, whatever the policy you changed, you have to take it back to the National Assembly. You don't just create a policy and just give it out. Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority 2006 Act has only three directories. She wants an increase more directory. When she increased more directory, what she did, she created that a private operator who is operating an aircraft Nigeria register, you are going to pay $3,000 per flight. $3,000 from here to Akure, or Abuja, or Maiduguri. If it's a private register, you are going to pay $4,000, and they create a separate account where that money will go. It has never done anywhere in the world. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So, and take for example, you have what we call EPXR, that's the maintenance organization. Each airline must have those kind of document. Normally, if that particular if they give you for air and it has XR, you go to renew it. They check your facility and they renew it for you. But guess what? Now you have to pay $10,000 for what? After the payment of the AOC, you have an AOC, you have everything, and all the charges come up. If you are having an airline and you need to go with your aircraft to put your catering, if you are serving by yourself, or you want to pick up your crew with your car to where you are going to the type of the airport we are having in this country. Do you understand? If you need an engineering vehicle to go inside the tarmac for checking the aircraft and so on and so on, or carrying tools or something, you have to pay 250,000 naira. Taya, which is free before. In the office space, every inch of the office space, every inch is 35,000 naira per an office space per square meter, my brother. So then you go to ODC, to every staff working there to get access to the tarmac, you have to get an ODC, which the ID cards, who will give you access to the tarmac. You have to go and renew it every year, and you have to pay about 2,000 naira before. Now it's almost 5,000 naira. So then you come as an airline, you want to park, you pay 200 naira before you get to the car park where you park, and you don't have a special place where you are going to park your aircraft. Even a captain has to look where he's going to park his car. He must pay 200 naira. My brother, anywhere in the world, you travel, you have a free trolley to push. But guess what? You land in Nigerian airport, you pay 200 naira, 400 naira for trolley.
All right.
Listen, to the extent whereby a church, I will not mention the church, provide a trolley free, thousands, millions, trolley. They want to corner it and lock it up, and they bring their own. They are collecting 400 naira from passenger. If you did not call this corruption, what are you going to call it?
Okay, we are really out of time. Let me ask you before you go. You watched the minister at the appearance she had at the House of Rep. What is your take about that appearance? Were you convinced by her response to the questions she was asked?
Well, first of all, already the National Assembly has already submitted a report. And the report is well known to everybody, and she has been indicted for that. Do you understand what I'm saying? And I believe the committee set up by Mr. President will do the same. That's what I can believe. And I hope that Mr. President will look at it. That what she did, she only tried to push all the blame to her head of Paracetal, which she shoot herself in the foot, because the head of Paracetal will run back and explain exactly what's happened. That's why we are thanking the MB fan, who is not afraid, a young man who wants to answer the truth. I have bought 4 cars, and I have given 2, and I have taken 2, and I'm driving 2 in my office. I think that's so wonderful for somebody like him to come and clear himself. So I hope other head of Paracetal will do the same to explain exactly what transpired, so that we can move forward. We can sit down and watch the industry destroyed.
All right, Mr. Mohammed Takur, thank you so much for coming on our show.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right. So when we come back, we'll continue to have our show today. And stay tuned because we still have some interesting shows to present to you.